For today's topic, CE6300A modulation encoding technique. For today's topic will be the introduction to electronic communication. I'm your OLC from Engineering Department from AMA Makati. Okay, good afternoon. We start. Okay, today's module learning outcome will be the introduction to electronic communication. By the end of this module, a student is able to understand the types of communication system and its use. The number two will be familiar with the modulation and multiplexing. Then number three, identify the classification of the common transmission and on electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, let's start. Okay, let's start with the types of communication system. Okay, as you can see, there are many types of communication system. Maraming type na mga communication system natin, lalo sa mga telecoms. Then, for example, mga network, katulad ng mga in mobile communication. Then, also in digital and data communication also. Okay, and also in broadcasting communication also. Okay, first we start with this type of communication system. The first one will be the optical communication system. From the word itself, optical, it means stands for light. Okay, familiar na rin naman kayo sa mga fiber optic or optic cable na ginagamit natin sa communication through the transmission of internet or data communication and digital communication. Okay, from the word itself, optical stands for light. As the name itself suggests, it is optical communication system depends on light as the medium for communication. From the word itself, optical, light. Ibig sabihin, ang nagiging medium natin dito is light. Alam naman natin, ang speed of light is sobrang bilis na constant value is 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per seconds. Okay, napakabilis na yan. Then, since napakabilis din yan, is mas mabilis din yung transmission ng data or information or yung ating internet connection. For example, in an optical communication system, the transmitter converts the information into an optical signal. For example, yung ating sa transmitter, okay, nasa optical communication tayo, then yung transmitter, bago ka mag-transmit ng information or data, is i-convert niya yung information para maging optical signal. Okay, what's since optical signals ito ay yung signal in the form of light. Okay? Since na-convert na ng transmitter yung information para maging optical signal in the form of light. And finally, the signal then reaches the recipient. Okay, alam naman natin sa transmitter, bago ma-convert ang isang information to optical signal or in the form of light, is nagkakameron tayong tinatawag na demodulation. Okay, i-demodulate niya muna para ma-convert sa into form of light na pwede nating i-transmit using also the medium as a light or yung ating space or sky wave na gagamitin natin na sa communication as a medium. Okay, next. The recipient then decode the signal and response accordingly. From the word decode, is ito na yung doon sa kabilang, side. Since nasa transmitter is demodulate, pagdating naman bago i-receive yun, is doon naman nagkakameron ng tinatawag nating ibabalik niya sa original form or doon magkakameron ng demodulation. Okay, that is dun sa receiver. Pagdating muna sa transmitter is modulation. Then after nun, ibabalik sa original form, dun na yung demodulation. Sa receiver naman yun. Kaya makikita natin sa recipient is then i-decode niya. Ibig sabihin, kung sa transmitter is ini-encode, then ibabalik niya naman sa original form dun sa receiver or tinatawag niyang decode. Okay, the recipient then decode the signal and response accordingly. Okay? Ibig sabihin sa kung gagawa tayo ng block diagram sa transmitter, doon nangyayari modulation or encoding. Then para ma-convert yung information to an optical signal. Then pagdating doon sa medium, yung pinaka-space or yung nasa gitna or yung channel, then pagdating naman doon sa kabilang side, kung may isa pa tayong block diagram, yung receiver, pagdating doon sa receiver, is doon na mangyayari yung decode or magkakameron ng demodulation. Then, the recipient decodes, then the recipient then decodes the signal and responds accordingly. Ibig sabihin, bumalik na doon sa original form. Yung original form, syempre, that is yung information. Kung light siya, kung optical, then i-convert na sa original form na information. Nangyayari yun sa receiver. Okay? In optical communication system, light helps in the transmission of information. Since sa optical communications, ito nangyari, alam naman natin, ang advantage ng light is sobrang bilis nung pag-transmit. Okay? Next, the safe landing of helicopters and aeroplanes work on the above principle. The pilot receive light signal from the base and decide their next movement. Okay, another example ng optical communication system is kinagamit natin to sa mga safe landing ng helicopter or sa communication between the helicopter and yung traffic controller or yung sa aeroplane naman is yung communication between the aeroplane at saka yung traffic controller, yung nagko-control kung safe na ba mag-land ang isang helicopter or isang airplane or aeroplane. Okay? Ito yung optical communication systems ginagamit siya sa safe landing ng helicopter and aeroplane works on the above principle. Then ito ngayon, the pilot receive a light signal from the base. Okay, nakaka-receive siya ng mga light signal from the base and decide their next movement. Okay, meron tayo sa mga communication or navigational na ginagamit dito is gumagamit siya ng light signal. Okay, through to have a safe landing of the helicopter and aeroplane. Then magde-decide sila kung ano yung next movement, kung magla-landing ba sila or kung pupunta sa left or side, right, or mag-stay lang doon sa isang location. Okay? On the roads, red light communicates the individual to immediately stop while the individual moves on seeing the green light. Okay. Another example nga nito sa optical communication system is yung red light. Alam naman natin pag red light communicates an individual to immediately stop while the individual naman na mag-moves is seeing the green light. Okay? In this mode of communication, light travels through the optical fiber. Okay, ang ginagamit namang communication na mode dito para mag-travel yung light is the use of the optical fiber. Okay? Okay, next, the next for communication system, we have a radio communication system. Ano naman yung radio communication system? Radio communication system, in the radio communication system, the information flows with the help of a radio. Okay, from the word itself, gumagamit tayo ng radio. Or ang communication natin, alam naman natin ng radio is marami siyang frequency band, then depende kung kilohertz. Ang example ng kilohertz or nag-ooperate sa kilohertz is yung mga AM station natin or amplitude modulation station. Then kapag matataas ng frequency naman nasa megahertz is ang nag-ooperate usually is yung ating FM station. Okay, then sa mga communication naman or mobile communication is iba pa yung mga ginagamit nila, matataas na mga gigahertz na. And sa mga television also, para mag-transmit ng mga data or information o yung broadcast is matataas din ang ginagamit, nasa gigahertz. Okay, let's continue. Radio communication system works with the aid of transmitter and a receiver, both equipped with an antenna. Okay, alam naman natin sa radio communication, kung familiar kayo, kung AM or FM station ang pinag-gagamitan ng application, is gumagamit tayo at sa simula muna, yung magta-transmit ng data or information or sound, that is the transmitter. Then sa kabila ng mga mag-receive ng signal or information data or yung speech is yung receiver that are both equipped with an antenna. Siyempre yung antenna is yung naghahanap ng signal or reception, then siya yung magta-transmit at both end, sa transmitter at saka sa receiver ng information or data or speech or yung mga sound. Okay, the transmit or yung electromagnetic wave. Ang electromagnetic wave kasi ginagamit natin to sa television eh, tsaka sa mga matataas na frequency katulad ng mga mobile communication. Okay, the transmitter with the help of an antenna produces signal which are carried through radio carrier wave. Okay, as I said before, magsisimula muna siya sa transmitter. Then meron din sa meron yung transmitter is meron siyang antenna that this will produce a signal which are carried through radio carrier wave. Okay. Itong signal na to, since meron tayong antenna, is ito yung mag-carried ng radio carrier wave. Ano ba yung kine-carried niya? Usually, makine-carried niya na radio carrier wave is yung mga electromagnetic wave also. Okay? The receiver also, with the help of antenna, receive the signals. Since ang transmitter is may antenna rin, pagdating naman sa receiver is paano siya marireceive niya yung ano, yung radio carrier wave is dapat is meron din siyang antenna at the both side. Kaya the receiver also with the help of an antenna receive the signal. Okay? Some information is unwanted and must be discarded and hence the electronic filter help in the separation of radio signal from other unwanted signal. Okay, ano ba yung mga unwanted signal? Since meron mga unwanted signal o tinatawag nating noise, yan yung mga random signal na sumisira dun sa signal or dun sa information or from the word itself unwanted, ibig sabihin hindi talaga siya kasama sa binabato na radio carrier wave or signal. Since nahaluan siya ng mga unwanted or mga discarded na mga information or yung mga noise, is kailangan natin gumamit ng electronic filter pagdating dun sa receiver. Kaya yung hence the electronic filter help the separation of radio signal from other unwanted signal. Okay? Naihiwalay na yung mga unwanted signal through the use of electronic filter. Which are further, since naiwalay na yung mga noise or yung mga unwanted signal after ng filtration or filter, pagkatapos nun is magkakameron tayo ng which are further amplified o kaya palalakasin yung isang signal to an optimum level, then this will be finally the signal are decoded. Doon nangyayari yung decoded or nagkakamera ng decoded. Kumbaga, binabalik sa original form, tinatanggal yung mga unwanted signal. Then after matanggal yung unwanted signal or mga noise, is doon na i-amplify. Then doon na nangyayari yung optimum level, then the signal are decoded in information. Okay, ibig sabihin bumalik na doon sa original form na information. Which can be easily understood by the individual. Okay, for example, yung information is sound, or kung sa television naman is TV, doon, may ibabalik na doon, kumbaga na-receive na. Which can be easily understood by the individual for them to respond accordingly. Okay, that is the example of a radio communication sa AM and FM station. Okay? Okay, ito naman yung mga type ng communication system. Meron tayong tinatawag na duplex. Ano ba yung duplex? Okay, from the duplex communication system, two equipments can communicate with each other in both the direction simultaneously and hence the name duplex. From the word duplex, ibig sabihin dual or two. Meron tayong dalawang equipment na nagko-communicate with each other in both. Okay. For example, telephone or yung walkie-talkie dati, ganito kasi yung duplex eh. Two equipment can communicate with each other in both directions simultaneously sabay. Ibig sabihin, pwede tayong magsalita or pwede kang makinig That is, usually, ang duplex communication is pumapasok dito yung telephone. Kung sa ngayon, or tinatawag nating mobile communication, pumapasok dito yung ating mga telephone or cellphone. Okay, kasi pwede kang magsalita, pwede ka rin makinig. Sabi kayong nagsasalita, sabi din kayo. Ay, ganun yun, simultaneously. Okay, when you interact with your friend over the telephone, ito yung type ng duplex. Both of you can listen to each other. As I said before, pwede kayong mag-listen to each other at the same time. Then the sender send the signal to the receiver who receive it, and then there are also give his valuable feedback to the speaker for him to respond. Okay, yan yung isang application ng telephone or mobile. Pumapasok siya sa duplex. Hence, the communication actually takes place between the speaker and the receiver simultaneously. Okay? Okay, pwede kayong simultaneously makipag-usap or makinig sa isa't isa. Yan yung example is telephone. Yan yung example ng duplex communication. Meron kasing half duplex naman is one at a time, magsasalita ka or makikinig. Yan yung mga example is yung mga walkie-talkie. Yun yun, mga example nun ng half duplex. Okay, next. Okay, we're done with the duplex communication. That is the example is the telephone or mobile. Okay, let's continue. In the duplex communication system, two devices can communicate with each other at the same time. Then these are the type of communication system involves the sender and the receiver, where the sender is in charge of sending signal and the recipient only listen to it and respond accordingly. Such communication is also called a simplex communication. Okay, kanina kasi ito yung duplex communication. Pwede kang both the directions simultaneously or makipag-usap ng sabay or makinig simultaneously, duplex. Sa simplex naman, ito yung type ng communication system also involves na yung sender at saka receiver, where yung sender is in charge na magsesend siya ng signal. Then ang mangyayari lang doon sa receiver is yung recipient only listen to it and respond accordingly. Okay, ito yung mga example ng simplex communication. Okay, ibig sabihin one at a time. Ibig sabihin yung sender is magse-send siya ng charge siya ng magse-send ng signal. Then yung recipient lang is ang gagawin niya lang is makikinig or only listen to it and response accordingly naman. Okay? Pagkatapos na receive yun, ito namang recipient ang magse-send naman ng another signal. Then yung isa namang sender ang magiging recipient, makikinig dun sa isesend na signal. Okay? Okay, ano naman itong half duplex? As I said before, mayroong ibang type ng mga duplex. In half duplex communication system, both the two parties cannot communicate simultaneously. The sender has to stop sending the signal to recipient and then only the recipient can respond. Okay, ito yung, for example, yung walkie-talkie, as I said before. Ito yung example ng half duplex. Dito kasi sa simplex naman is kung ikaw lang yung sender, ikaw lang yung charge na magse-send ng signal. Kung ikaw yung recipient, ang mangyayari lang sa'yo is only listen to it. Then, after nun, pwede ka rin naman mag-respond accordingly. Kaya yun yung sa simplex. Okay, ano naman yung half-duplex? Half-duplex communication system, both the two parties can communicate simultaneously. The sender has to stop sending the signal to the recipient and then only one recipient can respond. Okay, isang recipient lang ang pwede mag-response. Then hindi dalawang parties or the two parties can communicate simultaneously katulad nung sa duplex or yung sa full duplex. Kasi dito half duplex lang siya. Yun nga, yung two parties cannot communicate simultaneously. Then the sender has to stop sending the signal to the recipient and the only recipient can respond. Ito nga example ng walkie-talkie. Okay, for example, ikaw yung magsasalita. Magsasalita ka lang, then yung isa namang makikinig sa'yo is makikinig lang. Okay? A walkie-talkie works on the half duplex communication system. Then, for example, the application of this half duplex. The military personnel, while interacting, has to say over. Okay, meron silang mga code over, then for example, ginagamit din yung alpha, beta, para mas madali sila mag-communicate sa walkie-talkie. Ginagamit kasi ito sa mga military personnel eh. Kaya may mga code din sila ng word. Okay, for example, the military personnel while interacting has to say over for the other person to respond, then he need to speak the security code. For example, Bravo or Beta. Okay, he needs to speak the security code para alam nung nasa kabilang side na yun talaga yung kausap niya. He needs to speak the security code correctly for the other person to speak. Then the other party will never communicate unless until the code is correct and complete. Okay? Since ginagamit siya sa mga military operation or military personnel, nagkakameron ng mga code na word na para malaman kung legitimate ba or original yung kanyang kinakausap or yun talaga yung tao na kinakausap niya. Is tama. Okay? Okay, how about tactical communication? Ano naman yung tactical communication? Tactical communication system, another mode of communication is the tactical mode of communication. In this mode of communication, communication varies accordingly to the changes in the environment, condition, and other situation. Okay, from the word itself, tactical, ibig sabihin, sa mode ng communication na to is nagbabari siya or nagbabago. Depende rin dun sa environmental condition and other situation. For example, all the modes of communication work for a common objective is to transfer the information from one party to the another party. Okay, for example, ito yung mode ng communication. Is common lang objective niya is para ma-transfer yung information from one party to other party. Then the various model of communication system help us to understand the route of flow of information from the sender to the recipient through some medium. Okay? Ibig sabihin, meron siya mga various model na communication. Pag sinabi natin various model, is meron siya mga procedure or format kung paano sila magko-communicate. Then paano maiintindihan yung route ng flow ng information from the sender to the recipient through some medium. Okay? That is tactical communication system. Okay, as a review, these are the types of communication system. We are done with the optical communication system. Then we are also done with the radio communication system, duplex communication system, and half duplex communication system. And the last part will be tactical communication system. Okay, we are done with that lecture. Okay, now we discuss what is modulation. As I said before, nasabi ko yan kanina, is nasa transmitter siya, na side or device. Okay, ano ba yung modulation? Modulation is the process of transforming a carrier signal so that it can carry the information of a message signal. Then it is superimposed. It is superimposes the content of the message signal over a high frequency carrier signal, which is then transmitted over communication channel. Okay, ibig sabihin, bago tayo mag-transmit ng isang signal or isang or information from papunta sa receiver, nasa transmitter muna tayo or magkakameron tayo ng modulation. Ito yung process na itatransform natin yung carrier signal so that it can carry the information. Since na-transform natin yung carrier signal o yung magka-carry ng signal, then para ma-carry yung information of a message signal, then this one is superimposes the content. Sino superimposes niya? Kumbaga binabago niya yung form. Katulad kanina is yung information is nabago para maging lights. Then after nun is matatransmit na siya or through the transmitter. Then after nito, it superimposes the contents of the message signal over a high frequency carrier signal. Since gumagamit tayo ng high frequency carrier signal niyan, nasa, for example, sa AM station, nasa kilohertz. Kung FM station naman is nasa megahertz, kung mga sa television or malalayo yung bato or transmit ng information, is nasa gigahertz. Katulad nun sa mga microwave communication. Okay, it superimposes the content of the message signal over a high frequency carrier signal which is then transmitted over a communication channel. Yung sa communication channel, dito na pumapasok yung mga skywave propagation, ground wave propagation, then depende na lang siya sa communication channel. Usually naman, ang communication natin ngayon is nasa wireless communication. Okay, kung gumagamit naman ng mga cable, that is tinatawag nating wire communication naman siya. Okay, ano naman yung modulation? Meron tayong dalawang type ng modulation, that is yung analog modulation at digital modulation. Okay, depende sa application ng information or depende sa modulation siya. Okay, pag digital, usually mga new technology na. Okay? Okay, ito yung pumapasok yung mga type ng mga analog modulation at digital. Okay, sa analog modulation, can be category in three types. First is the amplitude modulation, okay, yung mga AM station natin, that is analog modulation. Then frequency modulation, FM. Then meron pa tayong isa na analog modulation na phase modulation. Okay, how about in digital modulation? Ano naman yung mga example niya? Is broadly divided into two categories then. Meron tayong bandpass modulation as in baseband transmission. Ibig sabihin dito sa bandpass modulation, ang pinapadaan lang natin na or pinifilter natin sa modulation is nasa baseband transmission. Baseband ang ginagamit na pag-transmit ng information or yung ating carrier na signal or information na signal. Or sa passband modulation naman, ang ating ginagamit dito na principle is nasa passband transmission. Okay? Yung way niya ng pag-transmit. Okay, that's the two types of digital modulation is broadly divided in two categories. That is the bandpass modulation as in baseband transmission. Then the other one is passband modulation or as in a passband transmission. Okay? Okay, ito yung mga example ng digital modulation scheme. Okay, sa digital modulation scheme is dito pumapasok ang dalawa. Yung baseband modulation at passband modulation. Doon muna tayo sa baseband modulation. Ang sumasakop sa kanya o yung mga nasa loob ng baseband modulation kung paano mag-transmit is yung NRSA. Okay, yun yung way niya paano mag-transmit. That is non-return to zero. Then another one is NRSA-I or tinatawag na sa non-return to zero invert. Okay, yun yung way or category in baseband modulation. We have also the Manchester encoding. Okay, makikita naman natin for the word encoding, ibig sabihin nasa transmitter yan, nag-i-encode. Then another type of baseband modulation or category, that is the bipolar encoding. Okay? Okay, tapos na tayo sa baseband modulation. How about in passband modulation? Ano yung mga category niya or mga type niya? Sa passband modulation, we have ASK. Or ang way naman niya is true amplitude shift keying. Then kapag FSK naman, that is frequency shift keying naman ang ginagawa niya. Ito. Kapag PSK, that is phase shift keying naman siya. Then the other one is BPSK or binary PSK or binary phase shift keying. From the word is at binary, ibig sabihin 0 and 1 ang pinagagamitan niya or computer language 0 and 1. Okay, yun yung paraan ng passband modulation or pag mo-modulate niya. Okay? Okay, next we have the multiplexing. Ano naman yung multiplexing? Sa communication, ang multiplexing is this is a method of combining more than one signal over a share medium. Ibig sabihin, kung familiar ka, i-discuss lang natin katulad ng isang bus. Then maraming sumakay na signal doon, pero ang isang ginamit niya lang na medium is yung bus. Ganyan ang example ng multiplexing. Kaya kung familiar kayo sa mga communication, for example sa TV, meron tayo doon mga isang nagmamay-aring network, pero marami siyang channel. Doon na nangyayari yung multiplexing. Okay, ibig sabihin, hinahati-hati niya lang yung share medium, nag-share-share sila doon. Pero isa lang ginagamit na frequency band din doon. Kumbaga nagahati-hati lang sila. Okay, that is multiplexing. It's divide the capacity of a communication channel into several logical channel. Okay, familiar na rin kayo dyan sa isang network or sa ating mga television na isa lang siya, isang channel lang ginagamit niya. Pero is nahati-hati ito pwede sa mga ibang logical channel. Okay? Kaya mapapansin niyo may mga network din tayo is meron siyang television network. Then meron din siyang pang FM at saka AM station. Okay? Ganoon na nangyayari. Kaya advantage din itong multiplexing. Multiplexing divide the capacity of communication channel into a several logical channel. Then each for a data stream. The method of extracting the original data stream from the multiplex signal is called demultiplexing. Okay? Ito naman yung paano i-extract or ibabalik sa original form yung data na stream. Since stream na yung ginagamit natin or internet na is through the use of demultiplexing. Okay? Yun yun naman yung demultiplexing. The method of multiplexing are as a follow. Okay, ito yung mga example ng multiplexing. Okay, usually ginagamit natin ito sa data stream. Okay? Okay, that is the example. For example, in multiplexing, okay, pwede tayong gumamit ng frequency division or FDM. Sa multiplexing uli, ay pwede naman tayong gumamit ng time division multiplexing. Then sa another multiplexing is gagamit din tayo ng CDM or code division multiplexing. Okay, ang advantage kasi ng multiplexing is a method of combining more than one signal over a shared medium. Okay, isang medium lang yung gagamitin niya, then magbabato tayo ng isang information, then magkakasama na yung lahat doon. Then multiplexing also divide the capacity of communication channel, yung capacity ng communication channel into a maraming several logical channel. Okay? Each is used for a data stream. Then, the method of extracting, para extract naman natin yung original form na transmit natin, is yun doon na yung mangyayari yung demultiplexing. The method of extracting the original data streams from the multiplex signal is called demultiplexing. Okay? Ito naman yung mga type ng method ng multiplexing. Nireview ko lang din. That is yung FDM, that is frequency division multiplexing. TDM, time division multiplexing. And CDM is the code division multiplexing.